Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and today Android 11 Beta 2 was released to beta testers. This is available for all current supported devices, so that means the Pixel 2, 2 XL, and newer. I'm running it on the Pixel 3a XL, but as long as you have a newer Pixel device than the Pixel 2, you're good to go, and you can run this. Now, it will come out later to other devices, but that's when it's actually fully released. Now, this update brings stability, and this particular update came in at a fairly large 1.35 gigabytes on my Pixel 3a XL. Let's take a look at the build number and then we'll talk about what's new. You'll see the build number is RPB2.200611.009. And this particular update has some nice changes here and there. It's more about stability, but there are some changes to features and things they've updated. So the first thing is if you go into your themes, press and hold on the home screen, go to styles and wallpapers, go to style, you'll see down here it's only style and wallpaper now. It used to say clock, there's no longer clock. So they've removed that for some reason. It's no longer there, but it's gone for now. Maybe they'll bring it back later, but this is what it looks like. They've also updated picture in picture to give you a little bit of a hint as to how you make the picture in picture window larger. So let's go into my Pixel update video, turn the volume down just to make it a little bit easier to hear, swipe up. It goes to picture in picture. And if you look in this corner in the upper left, that lets me know that I can resize it by tapping. So that gives you an idea. You can move it around whatever you'd like, and it will sort of shrink itself, bring itself back up, and then we can close it, of course. So pretty simple and straightforward, but it's a nice little hint that that's what you can do. Now in Android 11 Beta 2, the multitasking or the recents has been changed a little bit. At the bottom, you can see it says screenshot and select. They've removed an option. So it's not a huge deal, but it's something that's a little bit different. Now, another option I've noticed that's different is if you press and hold the power button, you'll see that we have three options along the top. We have emergency, power off, and restart. However, if you have the screen lock on or lockdown option, this will change. So let me turn that on. So you'll see if you search for lockdown, we'll turn it on here. There we go. And if we press and hold the power button again, you'll see that it's combined power and restart. So if we press on power, it's now a combined power button. It's just a slight little change if you have the lockdown button turned on. Now with notifications, you may have noticed that it looks a little bit different. It's slightly condensed, and we'll talk about the media player here or media controls it in a moment, but you'll see it's slightly condensed. You can kind of see more in less space, and they've also given conversations their own options within our settings. So if we go into our settings here, we'll just go down to settings, and then we go to apps and notifications. Now we have conversations. So if I had a priority conversation, it would be here, and then I'd have separate options for it. Before, you had to press and hold to get these options. So they're built in this way now. Now, if you take a look at the media controls, you'll see I have a song here, and if I press and play on it, it has this new effect. So it's sort of a ripple effect. If we press and hold, hit next, go back, it's a new effect within this media player. And also this media control is here by default. Before, you had to turn on a setting in order to get it to show up. Now it's just here all of the time until you close the app that's playing the media. And finally, if we pull down here a little bit, swipe over, we have a new screen record button. So the button has been changed a little bit. And when we press on this, we can now record audio from different sources. So we now have the option for device audio and microphone, or microphone. So you can change that up a little bit, turn it on, hit start, and now we're screen recording. So we can swipe back and forth. We'll go back and tap to stop the screen recording, and it should be saved. So it says screen recording saved. And again, it's got screen recording built in. You'll see it's doing its thing there. So it's nice that they've built that in. It's really nice to have that. And that's all that they've really changed so far, at least that I've been able to find. Now, there are some others that have said if you go into your app drawer here, it will say all apps. I still have the line. I haven't seen that update as well. But right now, those are the only changes within this particular update. So I think they've refined it, made it more stable, and hopefully it'll be good to go when it's set for final release later this fall, depending on what they have for a release date. It seems like that may be pushed slightly as well. However, performance using it a little bit, it seems to be pretty good. I would imagine battery will be about the same, although I haven't really used this phone on Android 11 Beta 2 for any amount of time, so I really can't speak to battery. It takes a few days to know that, but in general, the first beta was okay. There were a few bugs here and there, especially with picture-in-picture, but it should be a little bit better now. So that's it for this particular update. Let me know if you've found anything else in the comments below, and if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already, though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.